Welcome to Management Study with Channel. In today's module, we'll discuss about the very important topic of management, that is Henry Fayol's principles of administrative management. In the previous video, we have finished one of the classical approach, that is scientific management approach given by Taylor. So today we are going to finish the second classical approach, that is administrative management approach given by Henry Fayol. Introduction. Henry Fayol, a French industrialist, also called as the father of administrative management. He focused on the problems of top-level management. Management is a universal phenomenon. So according to Henry Fayol, the principles are general guidelines and they cannot be mechanically applied. So management of business has become very complex these days. That is the reason managers are expected to deal with the number of problems in day-to-day working. Some guidelines are needed which will help managers to run their concerns smoothly and efficiently. Henry Principles of Management. Henry Principles of Management are also called as 14 Principles of Management, otherwise Basic Principles of Management, friends. So here you can see the first letters of each word I have highlighted in red color. Why I did this? Because many of us will get confused how to remember all these 14 principles. So I have made in an order. Many of you know this, but I'm telling those who don't know can follow this so that they can easily remember this without any confusion. So if you read all the first letters of these words, you can frame a sentence. Here I have given a tip to remember. See friends, here I have given that sentence. Dad, you see USSR? Oh, I see. So this is like a sentence. Dad, did you see USSR? Oh, I also have seen it. So like that, it is like a sentence. So if you remember this sentence, you can easily frame up these 14 principles. So what is that, friends? Once again, I'm giving the tip. Dad, you see USSR. Oh, I see. Okay. The principles are division of work, authority, discipline, unity of command, centralization, unity of direction, scalar chain, or hierarchy, stability and tenure of personnel, remuneration, order, initiative, subordination of individual interest to common goal, equity, esprit de corps. So now let us discuss all the 14 principles in brief, friends. Division of work. Fayol advocated division of work to take advantage of specialization. It implies division of total work or the task. This helps to avoid the wastage of time and one person does only one thing rather than doing everything by himself. Work is allocated based on the specialization of that employee. The more people specialize, the more efficiently they can perform the work. Authority. It states that authority and responsibility should go side by side. A person can be accountable for certain work only if he has been given authority for getting the work done. Fayol viewed that people seek authority and fear responsibility. That means people will seek the authority and they'll get scared about this, their responsibility. Discipline. It means obedience, respect of authority, and observance of rules and regulations. Discipline is essential for smooth running of business, good supervision at all the levels, clarity of rules, system of the records, and punishment will help to maintain discipline. Members in an organization need to respect the rules and the agreements that will govern the organization. Discipline results from good leadership at all levels of organization, fair agreements, and enforced penalties for the infractions. Unity of command. It states that one person should receive orders from only one superior. One person must be accountable to only one boss. So there is no confusion to the subordinate whose orders to be followed first. He believed that when an employee is reported to more than one manager, conflicts in instructions and confusion and authority would ultimately result. Centralization. It refers to the extent to which authority is concentrated or dispersed. Management should control the authority to the extent that neither there should be too much concentration of power nor it divides too much. Management should see the maximum results are realized from all the faculties of personnel. Individual circumstances will determine the degree that will give the best overall yield. unity of direction. According to this principle, each group of activities with the same objective must have one head and one plan. Unity of direction is concerned with the functioning of the organization in respect of its grouping of activities or planning. Unity of direction provides better coordination among various activities to be undertaken by the organization. Scalar chain or hierarchy. It refers to the chain of superiors ranging from ultimate authority to the lower ranks. A hierarchy channel is also called as scalar channel. Scalar channel suggests that each communication going up or coming down must flow through each position in the line of authority. It can be short-circuited only in special circumstances when it's rigid. Following would be detrimental to the organization. For this purpose, Fayol has suggested gangplank, which is used to prevent the scalar chain from bogging down the action. Stability in tenure of personnel. Every employee must ensure the security of the job. Production level can be increased with the experienced staff. Instability of tenure is the evidence of bad running of the organization. So, no employee should be removed within a short time. Remuneration. Remuneration of employees should be fair and provide maximum possible satisfaction to both the employees and the employers. It depends on a number of factors like cost of living, demand for factors, general economic conditions, and the value of the employee. Order. It relates to the arrangement of things and people. It refers to engaging the right person in the right job and right material in the right place. In other words, simply we can say that placing the right man in right place. Initiative. Managers should encourage their employees to take initiative within the limits of the authority and the discipline. Initiative increases zeal and energy on the part of human beings. Employees should be welcomed to make any suggestions which should receive proper consideration by the management in formulation of its objectives and plans. Subordination of individual interest to the common goal. Individual interest must be subordinate to general interest when there is conflict between the two. The agreement between the employers and employees should be fair, and there should be constant vigilance and supervision. Equity. Equity is a combination of justice and kindness. It simply means justice and kindness. It should be shown to the employees of the organization, and it want to encourage workers to fulfill their duties. So there should not any favoritism, and all should be given fair treatment in the organization. Esprit de corps. Esprit de corps denotes union is strength and extension of unity of command for establishing the teamwork. It means the spirit of loyalty and devotion which unites the members of a group. Now, limitations of administrative theory. Principles of management not accepted all over the world in today's competitive environment. Some principles of Fayol conflict with each other, such as the principle of specialization, which conflicts principles of unity of command. Classical theorists ignore important aspects of organizational behavior and do not solve the problems of leadership, motivation, power, or informal relations. The main objective of classical theory is to increase productivity, so it does not consider the impact of internal and external environment forces affecting the organization. So friends, hope you all like the video. Please like and subscribe the channel for the latest updates. Thank you.